It's fun to do scenes with people who don't drop the comedy ball, which is nice, you know. It always feels good and safe and easier to play when other people know what they're doing too, so it's good. I think it's pretty well balanced. I think that, you know, the men are certainly imperfect and the women are wildly imperfect as well, and I think that it's kind of a good trade-off, you know, of power roles, and I think sometimes they're on top and sometimes we're on top, and I think it's good. And I think that the Jeff and Audrey relationship is sadly and oddly similar to a lot of real relationships, you know, in that sometimes he wins, sometimes I win, and sometimes nobody wins, but it's funny in the process. Oh, God, there have been so many. I mean, there have been so many that I loved that it's really hard. I love the ones where my character behaves really poorly and very self-centeredly, which is pretty much every episode, but there was one actually where Spade's character loves musical theater and it's a big secret, so that was incredibly fun to play because he just went way over the top with how much he loved musicals, and it was great. And then I sort of had something on him to lord over his head, both literally and figuratively. It was fun. But, for our characters, they're certainly exploring the surrogacy line of thought, which is odd and seems kind of heavy, but I think our writers have a great way of taking even really serious subjects and finding the funny in them. So, so we're looking for a surrogate, and I think she might turn out to be someone that Jeff... I don't know the exact storylines. They never really tell me, but I've heard all kinds of odd little quirks thrown in. The surrogate that we'd chosen becomes sullied by David Spade's character. That's all I'll say about that.
Yep, we've been talking about it for the last hour.
I'm so excited too. Okay.
Idiot.
Yeah, go back in there. Come on, go back in there.